I'm Rick Smith, and this is Labor History in 2.
On this day in labor history, the year was 1919. That was the day copper miners in Butte, Montana went out on strike. Mine owners announced a $1 a day wage cut when copper prices slumped in the financial markets. Swayed by the power of the Seattle General Strike then in progress, miners associated with the Industrial Workers of the World and the Metal Mine Workers Union Local 800 formed their own Soldiers, Sailors, and Workers Council. They issued a call for a general strike. For days, area trade unionists honored picket lines, left their jobs, and held meetings to debate joining a general strike. The streetcar workers shut down public transportation for 5 days. Soldiers returning from the war helped to man the picket lines. The labor paper Butte Daily Bulletin reported the post-war economy had left returning war heroes penniless and working in dangerous mines. While solidarity was unanimous among workers, their unions had yet to pass formal resolutions. Immediately, Montana's Governor Sam V. Stewart called in the 44th Infantry to crush the strike. Infantrymen bayoneted 9 strikers when they tried to stop the anti-labor Butte Daily Post from being distributed. Spirits were high by the end of the first week as official voting began. Then the streetcar men went back to work, citing no grievances with their employer. Then the engineers followed. Finally, the IBEW caved. They worried the engineers would take their jobs as they had done in the 1917 strike. The IWW and Local 800 called off the strike, fearing continuation would be fatal. Though most of the troops were soon withdrawn, one company stayed to ensure labor peace at the local water and electric works. Butte would remain under federal military occupation until the end of 1920.
Labor History in 2 brought to you by the Illinois Labor History Society and the Rick Smith Show.